Officials from the Ministry of Finance today made another attempt to persuade the committee to approve the inclusion of the 319 billion shillings in the 2022-2023 national budget for construction of Lubowa International Specialized Hospital. Finance Minister Matia Kasaija attributed the delayed completion of the hospital to lack of funds that saw contractors running away from the investor. The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, appealed to the committee to clear the government to sink more money into the controversial hospital, warning that the government is facing heavy penalties if it does not fulfill its commitments.
This is an obligation which government cannot avoid paying, and that's why we are praying that this money be maintained in the budget, because it relates to a commitment already entered into by government.
However, his submission angered committee members who rebuked the minister over his threats, saying investor Enrica Pinetti was the first to breach when she failed to complete the hospital project in the 2 years period penned in the agreement.
There are consequences, but already these people have broken an agreement. So why are you scaring us that there are consequences if we don't give? Actually, the minister is trying to scare this committee to give them money that we are going. What are the consequences? And they are the ones supposed to be facing consequences because they broke the agreement. This hospital should be standing right now. It should be visible.
Shouldn't allow to give, to allocate more resources to the ministry because they failed to show the outcome from the other resources which were allocated before. 1.4 trillion shilling, that's a lot of money.
The construction is not there, there is no contract on site, so it is really a lot of quara quara.
They vowed not to approve the 319 billion shillings appropriation for Lubowa Hospital when there are no works taking place at the site because the investor has no contractor on ground.
We'll be given bins full of weevils. What we are doing is our oversight work. We should be allowed to see the work that has been done, quantify it in relation to the money released. We cannot support wastage of public funds.
Who would hold the responsibility for issuing that certificate? The quality of work done on the ground, because they are the experts. If they issue the certificates, it means now they are willing to put their life on the line. Yes.
It's unfortunate that Lubowa has become a conduit for corruption. Many times, for example, more than 300 billion were appropriated for Lubowa project, but up now there is no accountability. Even inspecting and supervising progress on ground is hardly done. And it's impossible when you go, you are welcomed by militias. It is a highly guarded place. No one knows what is going on ground, but there is no photographic expression of what is on the ground, no architecture or proof that there is any involvement in Lubowa.
The committee also rejected evidence from the Ministry of Finance regarding progress of works at the facility, which was tabled to convince MPs, saying it lacked certificates of completion issued by the project engineer of the Ministry of Health.
How possible? Because we really want to ensure that government meets its obligation, but we cannot, our hands are tied to do that, to allocate the 319 billion. If we don't know what the physical work, the minister himself said he has not been there for over 5 years. No, but you know, you pay for works, you are motivated to spend more also, based on how far they are going.
This is just a schedule, madam, which was agreed in the agreement, and it is just a commitment. But what they've done is to redeem, based on a schedule.
The committee and the Ministry of Finance agreed to conduct an on-site visit tomorrow that will be used as basis to approve or decline appropriation of the money.
We pay a visit. It will take us 1 hour. Lubowa is not in Karamoja. It is just here on Entebbe Road. We shall even secure a lead car. So that the time is short and shift. And we go there.
I don't think this question should be put to vote. Me, I am very much with you. Let us go to Lubowa. We see the works, although we will not be having technical competence to assess what has, but at least to get an impression of what is on the ground.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.